have to resist.
All of us, yes, people have been hungry. This is not the first time, and nobody is happy that people are hungry. We are all working so that people, the burden on the shoulder of the people will be lifted up and will be carried away. The president has done this, the president has done that, the president is doing this, he's not doing that. When a government comes to power, we cease to be political party members. We cease to be PDP, we cease to be APC, we cease to be YPP, we cease to be any other party. We all now have a party called Nigeria. Party Nigeria, that's what we are. And we must all walk. No religion says that you must pray for your government to fail. Anywhere you see a small thing for the government to fail, immediately you jump in. The government must fail. This government will not fail. This government will not fail. This government will stand. We might have differences. We must also tell those in government that if you are in government, you must not use your power in government to suppress the people and to cause anarchy. There are people in government say, now we day, now we go deal with you. Enough you deal with me. Enough you deal with me. Me, enough you deal with me, I they tell you. Now me, they tell you, say enough you deal with me. So those who think they can deal with us, they should not spoil the government of Ahmed Bola Tinubu. Me, I know Ahmed Bola Tinubu. I have known him to his bedroom. And I know that there is no president that had come in this country that is like Ahmed Bola Tinubu. All of you know me, I don't flatter people. In fact, I specialize in abusing people. So I don't flatter people. I don't. President Ahmed Bola Tinubu and Sammy Imbuku, Dennis Otuaro, and others are people who were in the trenches with us. This is the first time a president that is one of us is in Aso Rock. And that's why we must support him. Because we know that he's dealing and interacting with people who do not understand what we went through, what we have. We have paid our price from June 12th to today. We have paid our price. We have gone to prison. We have been underground. We have been buried alive. We have every right to earn our respect. We are telling you, don't go. Look, what they want to do is to come here to blow pipelines, to intercept trucks, trucking, to intercept badges. You heard what happened in Imo State yesterday, where they killed police officers. That is what they want to do. And we must resist them. We must not allow them to bring their anarchy here. But if you get stronger, you bring them. If you get stronger, you bring them. I know the Tinubu, I know the government, I know the Chief of Army Staff, and not be IG of police. If you do anyhow, you go see anyhow. Don't bring your protest here. This protest does not concern us. And anywhere where you are doing your protest, I did there you are doing your protest, I know that you are a threat to me. I will be a threat to you. That is it. I'm not going to romance my words. I'm not going to do CCCC with you. I am not a CC. My name is Mujahid Okubasare, and I'm going to live up to my name, and I will stand firm. I'm not doing it because Ahmed Bola Tinubu is going to give me anything. No, I'm doing it because I believe that if I don't do it, my life will be in danger. The life of my children will be in danger. The life of my compatriot, all of you who are here, will be in danger. It is wrong for us to be part or even conceive these protests. Those who have lost election should prepare for 2027. Thank you.
This is not the Ahmed Bola Tinubu I know.
Since 1992, when I encountered you, I don't think this is the Ahmed Bola Tinubu I know. That calls me his friend, and I call him my friend. And calls me my son, and I call him my father. This is not Ahmed Bola Tinubu I know.
Asare Dokubo spent 11 minutes threatening Nigerians with guns, with violence, and in that same breath, he was adding a bit of an insurance, all of you in government. Now I have delivered. I hope all of you should know that we all suffered for this government and you need to take care of us too, kind of. But it will be on record. If there is violence during the protests, Asare Dokubo, who actually, because Nigeria is, Nigeria is a criminal's den. That is why somebody like Asare Dokubo could sit on a national TV and threaten the country, spitting and spewing gibberish and nonsense, and making himself feel good. He is a known Niger Delta terrorist, Niger Delta militant. A glorified name for terrorists in that part. Ijaw Youth Council, who have declared their own support for this. Asare Dokubo, collect your money and walk away. He is just a man. That is what the Niger Deltans are saying. Asare na one person. Na him go see anyhow. And they know him very well. He's only playing to the gallery for the likes of Akpabiole. I think Asare's, Asare's statement somehow boosted the confidence of Akpabiole. And Akpabiole made all these pledges to 10,000 Niger Delta youth every month. Listen. So if they tell you, say, protests, no, they work. See waiting protests they do, even before the day of protest. Now, Niger Delta, that Akpabiole and his gang gave their middle fingers for years. Suddenly, they care for them so as to stop them from participating in a protest.
Try to come. So the whispers of our nation is already receiving attention. The economic challenges are known by the president because all of us feel the impact of what is happening now. But we are aware that it will be for a short while. The specific issues faced by the Niger Delta must be contained in that communique because we are going to make it available to Mr. President. The ones that need legislation will come to us. The ones that need intervention will go to NDDC. The ones that need more money will go to the President and Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. And I assure you that those issues will be addressed. MD, I want to thank you for what you said. You said, we are not interested in regime change. Let us own this government. Those who want to protest can protest, but let us be there eating. Am I right? I must thank Niger Delta. So, in conclusion, we acknowledge the fact that the impact of oil and gas activities in our region has done immeasurable damage to our people. It reshaped our life, it reshaped our economy, it reshaped our environment. So we must expedite action to address those concomitant socioeconomic issues that have arisen as a consequence. Be rest assured that the Tinubu administration will release the necessary funds for critical projects in the Niger Delta region and will ensure that the needs of our people and our dreams are realized. Let me take a moment again to with vibrant colors, a tapestry woven with threads of unity, resilience, and determination. For Niger Delta, I see a people like the mighty Babau tree, standing tall and unyielding, rooted in the rich oil of her heritage. try to come.
Nuisance, Lily.
That was him. He was about to start pressing them and making, you know, massage their ego a little bit. They said, when you are protesting, 10,000 Niger Delta youths would have access to 50,000 naira each so that they don't need to join you. They can just go and drink and eat. So right now, the likes of Akpabiole has their own effort to cut down and reduce the participation or the effect of this protest. They are sharing money, be anything. But guess what? It's like giving people 10,000 naira, 20,000 naira, or 50,000 naira like they are doing, right? But people still have to go out there and unable to afford. How much is the liter of petroleum today? To those of you who are on the street, I think I have somebody who says something on that. Here, there's a report on that. What is it like today?
Residents will continue to decry the latest fuel supply crisis in Nigeria. Say buying premium motor spirit at the rate of 800 to 1,200 naira per liter in some of the filling stations is most insensitive at these very difficult times in the country.
If for now, petrol is 800 naira, 900 per liter. When we come here, we buy it 619. But the other people from Ifo, it's 800, 900, and some place for Ifo, no lights. We are using generator to pump water, to use it for lights, is generator. And our money is not get value again.
We had a very bad experience about this fuel issue. You know, there are a lot of queue. In fact, I traveled to Ibadan, that was last weekend. Could you believe I was stuck on the road? The rate that I bought fuel on the road, I queued for more than 1.5 hours. And at the end of it, I bought fuel at a rate of 1,200 naira per liter. What's happening in Nigeria?
Residents who spoke to AIT on the development say the number of man hours spent on queues remain worrisome, calling on the NNPC to quickly intervene to address the situation.
We want make you people beg our people, NNPC, to bring fuel. So the fuel is high too much. We are suffering. We transporter. See now, see my downfall here. 6 months and 3 years now, I cannot see fuel by. The fuel is cost.
For over 2 hours now, I've been on the queue. And the way I'm looking at the thing, there is possibility I stay more than 2 hours on this queue because they have not yet started selling the fuel.
While expressing concern on the implications of the current supply challenges, some of the motorists warned that a prolonged supply crisis may snowball into uncontrollable actions.
The economic situation is seriously affected as a result of this situation. And if government did not try as much as possible to intervene to this situation, it can generate into crisis. Because people that want to go to market, go to their places of work, and they left stranded as a result of fuel scarcity, before you know it, other things that they are not prepared for will begin to happen.
Amidst latest fuel supply crisis in some parts of the country, government and the NNPC have continued to reassure citizens that there is no cost.
To reassure them. Sorry about that. There's something I didn't go after that anyway. So give me a sec.
Who are those sponsoring protest against President Tinubu? There are three. One, Tinubu's own ineptitude. Two, unabated insecurity. Three, worsening mass abject poverty. Who are...
Thank you. Sorry about that. You know why I'm actually including what people are currently saying on their streets? The ones that APC, Egbekegbe, is doing everything to buy everyone buyable, but they do not have enough resources to buy everyone because the hardship, the economic destruction created by their incompetence and corruption has run so deep beyond what some of them can even imagine, but they will find out soon. So it is not those of us who are from outside Nigeria that needed to remind them in Nigeria anymore. It is not us that needed to motivate them anymore. Hunger, insecurity, corruption. There are enough things to move to motivate them. They have just been using so many tools and effort to suppress them, suppress their voices, and scare them to death. But whenever they have the chance of telling you what they actually will do, you will understand that, except for the fact that those criminals in Nigeria are living what you can call living in denial, a lot of us are about to experience what is called the rude shock. There are those who are getting ready. In Abia State, their governor, Alex Otti, broadcasted to the state today in advising the people what to do when the protest hit Abia State. If you ever hit Abia, Abia in particular, the people should do their best to make sure it is peaceful. That's kind, right? Let's go listen to him. It's a statewide broadcast, by the way. So, the first part.
Umunem Diabia, fellow Nigerians and friends, I bring you warm greetings from our dearly beloved capital city, Umuahia. Let me specially thank you for tuning in to this special broadcast where I shall be addressing a few important national issues, how they affect us here in the state, and the best part for us as a people in an earnest push for progress and genuine development. For the past few months, we have had expressions of dissatisfaction from various quarters. Recently, the sentiments of disaffection have snowballed into threats of protests across many regions, states, and cities in the country. Clearly, there is evidence that all is not well in the polity, as it would be uncharitable to dismiss the genuine angst of millions of our compatriots who have been caught up in the rising wave of economic troubles, such that despite their best efforts, they still struggle to meet their daily needs. We have to acknowledge that some of the measures taken by the central government to stop the hemorrhaging of our economy has brought severe hardship to many individuals, families, and organizations. Uncertainty has become rife, and there is widespread fear about what tomorrow may bring as biting inflation continues to frustrate the plans of individuals and businesses. While it is fair to acknowledge the present pain, it is also proper to realize that what we are suffering today is the culmination of years of poor judgment in the management of the national economy. The ill-advised policy decisions of the past, recklessness in the use of ways and means instrument of the central bank, and a certain inability to address rampant acts of economic sabotage all contributed to the distress now affecting millions of Nigerians. Much of the steps taken by the federal government, including removal of petroleum subsidy, are aimed at ending years of abuses and cronyism, and ultimately redirect national resources to areas of genuine needs, especially infrastructural development, and other initiatives that can improve the economy through job creation and holistic reset of the real sector to drive long-term growth. It was clear from the get-go that these corrective measures will come with pain and inconveniences. Even then, the expectation was that the pain will be short-lived, while the gains will ultimately set the national economy free to soar. So far, the expectations have not been materialized, and our compatriots are losing patience. This explains what now seems like a resort to protests for many who apparently have lost hope in the promises of economic rejuvenation. Again, I would like to acknowledge that the right to protest is a democratic one, which adds to the appeal of democracy. We are a democratic nation, and citizens to whom the leaders are all accountable to are free to always express their dissatisfaction, especially when their basic needs are not met. At any rate, the subject...
Let's jump forward, okay? Because it's like a 10-minute video, right? So this was them getting to that part to say, well, it's your right, it stays, it starts, but please make it peaceful. There's no threats against any protester in Abia State, okay? You are free to assemble, and you are free to push your demands, and everyone who wants to be part of that is welcome to be. And if you don't want to be part of that, you can still go about your normal businesses if you want to. There's, you know, he said more. Well, let's fast forward it a bit, okay, to this.
And community leaders led a mass movement to reclaim our state from the ruins caused by unaccountable leadership. Using the very same tools I'm advocating today, they disrupted the political dynamics in the state and installed a government that answers to them. Even in the face of injustice and extreme provocation, there was never a time violence became an option. 14 months after assumption of office, even those who saw our cause as a lost one now agree that indeed, nothing can beat the determined action of a group of sincere people motivated by the desire to make a change in their social and economic conditions. Abia, since May 29 last year, has seen unprecedented infrastructural development, and things we were told could not be done have now become routine activities. Hope is returning, and all that could have been imperiled by violence have now been attained by patience, firmness, and non-threatening dispositions. I would draw this broadcast to a close by calling on our young people in Abia State to adopt the principle of self-restraint in the wake of the widespread calls for street protests, lest what we worked hard to attain be destroyed by those whose objectives are at variance with yours. The new Abia is your baby and must be protected from whatever could present a threat to its continual development, especially in the urban centers of Aba and Umuahia, where we are investing massively in impact-driven infrastructural projects. It took so much sacrifice, tears, and blood to arrive at our present destination. We are therefore invited to resist any temptation to engage in acts that could unsettle our progress and return us to the better forgotten days of arson, destruction, and disruption. What every part of Abia needs presently is a high sense of order and peace so that citizens can go about their lawful businesses while we continue to push for the stabilization of the economy using less disruptive means, including regular engagement with our leaders and representatives at the various levels of government. I would at this point call on parents, religious and traditional rulers, youth leaders, and persons of influence to join the Abia State government in appealing to our young people not to lend themselves to any activities that could threaten the peace of our communities. If we have learned anything from a careful study of street protests over the years, it is the fact that things can become very unpredictable without a moment's notice, and the innocent could easily become victims. While the Abia State government remains committed to its statutory obligation of protecting lives and property, we must also know that as citizens, we have a very important responsibility in this regard by refraining from any action that may threaten the peace we currently enjoy. As a government, we shall continue to do our best to improve the living conditions of our people. We recently gave out 1 billion naira interest-free loans to 10,000 nano and micro enterprises across all the communities in the state. Workers in the state have just been paid a part of the combined 45,000 naira wage award promised them earlier in the month. These payments shall continue as we also seek new ways of ensuring that every group is catered for in the state's economic stimulus and support program.
And on and on and on. The bottom line, Shah, is that he is not saying it directly that, please, if you can just please not protest, please. But since I can't tell you not to, okay? But please, Abians, can you please protect the public properties from vandalism or from people burning properties and all of that?